My birthday party is on coming Sunday at Continental Pyramid Hotel, and I feel like I should invite you to celebrate with me. Will you be able to attend?
I'm ready and willing to go in.
Really? Oh yes.
You don't know about it. You don't know it.
Hi, what's up everybody? Welcome back to another comic interview with Danny211. Today we are having the President of the Republic of South Sudan, that is His Excellency General Salva Kiir Mayardit. If you have not watched the previous videos, make sure you check them out on our YouTube channel. And don't forget to hit that like button, comment, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more of comic vibes. And also follow us on our Facebook page that is displayed on the screen. Thank you. Good morning, Your Excellency. I am so much pleased to have you today. I know we have a lot of things to talk about, but first, do you trust the people working with you in the government?
Well, if I don't trust them, I cannot bring them around me.
If by chance I work in your government, will you be able to trust me?
Well, I can't think.
Do you regret being the president of South Sudan?
I can't regret.
Why?
I can't regret because when I was fighting for the liberation of this country, I did not choose any sector or any front to go and fight. But once you know my superiors by that time, appoint me that you go to that area.
Mr. President, you actively participated in the liberation struggle. You fought so many wars. Did you ever think you will survive all those dangers?
I never knew that I will come back alive.
So many people died at your watch during the liberation struggle, especially at front line. How was the experience?
I could have died. But I did not die.
Did you run away?
Not because I ran away, but my time did not come.
Since you took over the leadership after the death of our founding father, the late Dr. John Garang Mabior, so many things have happened, both bad and good. Do you see yourself giving another person a chance and you go for retirement?
Let us bring stability first.
Okay.
So that they know nothing will happen to them if I go.
Someone somewhere said the recently signed peace agreement will never end well. What do you think about that?
What proofs does that person have? It helps to end well. There are so many other countries where people were dying in mess. But that thing stopped at the end. They are now peaceful.
Have you ever called other political leaders and discussed exactly what is wrong within the leadership?
I told that to him, what is wrong with us?
So what did he say?
He did not answer me.
But do you think the problem is within, the top leadership?
I cannot answer. I can answer for myself. For me, I feel that there is nothing wrong with me.
Your Excellency, now the peace has been signed and things are returning to normal. Have you forgiven those who wronged you in one way or the other?
I have forgiven them all. Being the leader of this country, I have forgiven all those who took arms against me. And those who have been insulting me in the media, writing all the rubbish, I have forgiven them.
Tribal conflicts happen in South Sudan between Nuer and Dinka. What exactly is the problem here?
The Dinka and the Nuer, as tribes, have no problem.
So where's the problem?
The problem is with the people who want power. These are the people who go and mobilize the innocent people in the countryside, beating the drums that they are coming to fight Usage tribe.
When all these problems are solved, are you confident that South Sudan will be peaceful again?
I'm very confident.
As a leader, there are always criticisms, no matter what one does. How do you handle such?
Well, they never come to me to tell me. They talk very far away from me. In the media, talking to other people, but not in front of me.
All right, Your Excellency, how do you see South Sudan in 2 years to come?
Well, 2 years will be still in the interim, during the transitional period.
Will people be able to move freely in South Sudan and do their business without fear?
It is already there now. Free movement is now there. Although there are pockets of rebels that are still ambushing people, but it has now subsided.
What do you want the people of South Sudan to remember you for? I mean the coming generation.
Well, I have done many things that I can remember. I fought the war in the young age to this age that I have now grown old.
One more time, are you confident that South Sudan will be a better place to live in?
I'm confident that there will be peace and South Sudan will be one of the most lovingly countries that each one will want to come and live in South Sudan.
Will all this happen in your presence?
Without self, because how long will I live? I cannot determine that I will be there. But whoever that will come after me must find a very peaceful country to lead.
My birthday party is on coming Sunday at Continental Pyramid Hotel, and I feel like I should invite you to celebrate with me. Will you be able to attend?
I'm ready and willing to go in.
Thank you so much, Mr. President. Now, this is a personal question of which I don't want people to hear. The last time I met you, you probably knew something. Will it really happen?
Yes, it will happen.